today, and I am the lead facilitator for this induction program of female councillors in Sierra Leone.
What is the rationale behind this induction training for female councillors?
Well, the rationale for this particular training is really to set the stage for our female councillors to be able to know some of the basic issues around local council work, so that they are okay and they are very much prepared to ensure that they are able to carry out their roles effectively within the councils. So we are coming to have an induction so that we take them through some very basic processes of running the council and how they should conduct themselves once they go into the act of really working within the councils.
In less than 30 minutes, you'll be going into the training proper. What are the various steps you'll be going to look at into this all-important induction?
In this induction, we're going to let the councillors actually know, like, the historical background leading to the formation of local councils in Sierra Leone. We're also going to let them know how the local government financing is done. We're also going to let them know as to how they should be able to conduct themselves during meetings and be able to carry on some very specific roles effectively, and ensure at the end of it all for them to become very successful councillors.
So what are the expectations from the trainees so far, you as one of the lead facilitators?
Well, the expectation from the trainees is that, I mean, they're going to be equipped with some basic skills, skills around providing the required leadership as a councillor, skills around even how to develop proposals, and they are expected to imbibe a couple of issues that will account for them upon their return to be able to perform the role as councillors in their respective councils.
Generally, how important this will be to them?
This will be so important because it will let them be effective in their roles and their functions within the councils and set the stage for them. Once they face the electorate again in 5 years' time, they will have been so much effective councillors that the electorate will have no alternative but to put them in again. Again, we are looking forward to ensure that we have more female councillors. So with this number, we want to ensure all the female councillors that are here are retained, so that, I mean, through their work, as a result of this training, will ensure that they are able to retain their positions at the councils.
In a whole, all what is to be learned in this training could not be achieved without the support of the electorate. What is your message to the electorate in supporting the councillors that have benefited from this all-important training to see how best they could work hand in glove to achieve the goals?
Well, in the first place, we want to speak out to the electorate to say, once the councillor comes in, you will not expect that particular councillor to be below the castle in the air, meaning you can't expect so much. So, I mean, we want the electorate to really be considerate in their demands at the community level, but also to support those councillors, especially the female councillors, work with them and be able to provide what is needed for these councillors to succeed. So we're expecting a situation we are in, they will be able to work within the confines of the mandate of the council and provide what is needed so that the councillors in turn will be able to achieve what they intended to be the council.
Holistically, will this initiative continue? Because this is the first time most of them are going to benefit from this all-important session. Are we expecting continuity?
Yes, it is expected that this approach will continue, because I want to let you know that, in fact, for the first time also, BFB also supported the induction of members of parliament. So this particular induction process today will definitely continue, because we know that, there are a lot of attendance benefits to this kind of approach. First of all, especially for first time, it gives them a very clear picture as to what they expected to roll through in their roles as councillors. So we want to believe, based on the feedback we are receiving so far, we are of the firm conviction that this is a process that will continue. We will even want to be engaging the councillors during the course of the discharge of their work, so that we are able to understand their challenges, which in turn can inform as to what we can engage them in the future.
Proceeds of this nature will be expected to be forthcoming when?
The proceeds of this...
of this induction will be expected to be forthcoming when?
Well, in the process.
The proceeds
in terms of...
Like, seeing it coming back. Of course, you've ensured and also affirmed that there will be continuity in this whole important session. When are we expecting this particular initiative to be forthcoming again in subsequent time?
Well, you see, this is an induction, and then we get the councillors into the work. And then within the course of them working, we will do an evaluation, you know, to see how best they've been able to imbibe the concepts and how are they actually executing them at the community level in terms of their work. And then we will definitely want to ensure that there is an aspect of sustainability that is getting through to them and ensuring that, I mean, what they were taught is what they are actually implementing and which cause would be useful for their work.
All right, thank you very much, sir.